I was like just being aggressive as I can be, getting to the basket.
Well, that was fun, wasn't it? Just when it looked like the Orlando Magic were going to close out this matchup, the Boston Celtics did the unthinkable and staged a huge comeback to send the game into overtime and then ramped up the pressure to finish with a 116-111 victory as Jaylen Brown set a new career high with 50 points, becoming just the fourth Celtics player in franchise history to log 50 points and 10 rebounds in a single game.
To be honest, I didn't even realize until the last shot, like when I had 47. Other than that, I was like just being aggressive as I can be, getting to the basket. You know, I didn't feel like those guys could stay in front of me. So I was just gonna keep getting to the basket, keep, you know, blowing by them off the first step. And I looked up and I had 47 and I was like, damn. And then I hit the three that off the smart pass that made it 50. But I wasn't even really paying attention until it got to like 45 or 47.
The growth with JB is, it's very real. And I think we've all witnessed. I've been here for the whole part of it, and of his journey, I know it might not seem like it, but, you know, me and JB are closer than people probably think, you know, and we talk all the time and, you know, constantly, you know, just trying to keep his confidence up. He shot, I think it was 19 for 29 from the field, I think it was around 60%+, 50% from the three, and he was a plus 10, that just speaks about the growth about JB.
It's about time that he scores 50. I mean, he always scores in the first half, you know, when I was in health and safety protocol, I always, seen him score 25 or more, you know, in the first half or 20. But then in the second half, this time, he did what he's supposed to do.
As for the key in this turnaround, Marcus Smart said post-game it was about the Celtics team just keeping their composure and keeping with it. He said, sure, it wasn't pretty, but we pushed through and we got the W.